What about the person who says, yeah, but Beyonce has Michelle Obama saying that she looks up to her. Beyonce has our daughter's admiration. She's somebody the kids look to, and she was performing a certain model of what gender could look like. She's the one that said, us girls got to stick together. We run the world. And then you have, and Keisha Cole, for example, somebody who came on Twitter and says, well, one day you say we got to stick together, and now you're telling us to bow down. That Beyonce, because she has a particular stature and a certain amount of admiration, has a different type of response. I mean, if you had made a song about putting Molly in champagne, the world would be responding differently than if Rick Ross did it, even, because there's a heightened expectation.
Right,
of who
but
you
I do make plenty of songs. I'm considered a positive rap artist, but I make plenty of rap songs telling these other dudes, yo, fall back. I'm better than you. I make plenty of rap songs like that. And artists are contradictory. People need to get over it. Artists, just like every other human being, have different days, different moods, contradictions, and they should be allowed to express those contradictions.
Would you challenge Beyonce the same way you challenge Rick Ross?
No, I don't even listen to Beyonce. I don't even really listen to radio on the music. When that thing came down for me, I'm siding more with like, you don't need to do this. You're Beyonce in that sense. For me, why I challenge hip hop is because I love hip hop. I love the culture. I love that it's a global phenomenon that gives young people power to speak truth to power, to act, to organize it. And that it's never been, again, just about the lyric. But in this sense, the reason I keep saying it's the tipping point is because this song explicitly is talking about raping a
no doubt.
Raping. And we need to...
I think we're all on the same page on the Rick Ross thing.
But I thought it was in many ways counterproductive to a lot of what she's done. It's not to say that she can't have contradictions. It's not to say that she shouldn't be empowered to engage in hip-hop bravado. But at the same time, I think that when you simply are an extension of all the things that exploit and dominate us, when you use violent language, I don't see how you're furthering our empowerment. Just because she's a woman doing it, to me, is not a sense of empowerment. She's simply, and you can't even argue that she's mimicking it. If that is who she is, I gotta really wonder when you view putting women down and calling them tricks and bees and saying that, you know, they need to bow down to you and you'll smack them is how you feel empowered. Why does it take that for a woman to feel empowered?
Fair enough.
I think that there's a space to be contradictory. You know, I don't think there's anything wrong with bravado. And I think there's something cool about Beyonce, like considering her proximity to hip hop, you know, well before her marriage and the fact that she's married to one of the most famous rappers in the world, playing hip hop and taking on bravado and boasting. That's cool. I just think there's a way that you do it. And I didn't necessarily love the way that she did this. So even though the production was fun, it's just kind of like when the most popular girl in school, who's the captain of the cheerleading squad and the prom queen, kind of tells you all those things. It's not quite as fun as when the girl who's kind of off to the side and a little weird tells you how dope she is.